Okay, so hey, what's up guys, I'm NXNL, and in this video we will be reviewing the Gufone i6 in 4K. So now, let's get at it. Okay, so if you're interested in getting this phone, well, you can head over to gufone.hk, which is the official website. Okay, so let's start out the review with a gaming test. And as for the AnTuTu benchmark, well, this phone scored 20,500 points, which is a lot for a quad-core phone, as this phone runs MediaTek's MT6582 processor. And as you can see, when we compare it to the Samsung Galaxy S5, well, the only section in which it is better, because the S5 is basically an octa-core phone or quad-core depending on how you see it, that it beats it in the RAM speed section. Gufone has also made a great job in trying to mimic some of the application that you see on the original iOS, but as you can see, this is the Game Center app, sorry, and it doesn't work really good. Slash, it doesn't even work. And it is the same thing for the Passbook app. Other than that, well, they made a great job trying to mimic the OS. And a glitch that I found is that the compass doesn't work when you have the phone on a table or just like face down. And a trick that I found to fix this is to have the phone like just in front of you and just turn it clockwise or counterclockwise. Another downside is the fact that the GPS doesn't even work when you have Wi-Fi enabled, whether or not it is enabled or not. As you can see, it is always stuck on waiting for location, but there should be a fix on maybe another firmware update of this if you are able to find it on one of the official websites or if you're able to find another ROM. And continuing with some more cons, well, this phone, at the place of having Siri, well, it has Google Now, but every time, for example, you say Google Now, when it says speak now, it doesn't even work and it kind of lags at just as you can see right now on the screen. And to make this phone even more filled with random apps, they even have a second recorder again for some random reason. But what I like that they did with the phone is the fact, as you can see, but probably not on camera, is that if you look carefully, while there is like some kind of gyroscope action on the icons, and when you tilt the phone just a bit, it tries to do the same 3D action as you can see on the iPhone 6 and the iPhone 5S. And for a phone that was released before the actual version of the iPhone 6, well, the design is pretty good. And if you compare it to a iPhone 5 or a Gufone i5C, you can see that it is just a bit thinner than the i5C and just a bit thicker than the iPhone 5. But for some reason, at least to me, when you look at it from a side point of view, it looks like it is thinner than the iPhone 5. And comparing it to a bigger phone, the OnePlus One, it is actually thinner. Okay, so the design of the Gufone i6 is actually pretty nice, and I was able to compare it to a iPhone 6, but I don't have video of it, and the device is actually way lighter than the actual iPhone 6, but the design again is actually pretty dare. I'd recommend this phone for those that are fans of the Apple designs but that don't want to spend like $700 to $1,000 on the actual device, and they also prefer Android over iOS. Okay, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, well, leave them in the comment section down below. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at NXNLHBLA, and don't forget to check out my Facebook page, and also don't forget to follow me on Instagram at NXNL. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and again, don't forget to subscribe because it really helps out. So again, I guess that this is it. Peace.